I would like to explain about addressing modes in the 8051 microcontroller. Here, addressing modes in the sense here, actually I want to explain this as in this 8051 or 8086 or 8085, if you want to access the values stored in the memory locations or in the registers, we need a way. So this way can be achieved with the help of addressing modes. So, addressing modes in 8051. Okay. Here, as I said, to access the values, to access the values stored in the memory locations, or in registers. Now, here you may be asking, so why do we need this? Because if we take any processor or if we take any controller, we will be storing the values and retrieving the values. Here, storing and retrieving happens. Okay. Now, here, in order to do this storing and retrieving procedure, we will be using the memory locations or the registers in different ways. Okay. Now, we will see the types of addressing modes in 8051. So, types of addressing modes in 8051. Here, so we do have so different types of addressing modes in 8051. So number one as immediate addressing mode. Immediate addressing means immediate value. Now, how to store a value and where to store? In this 8051 microcontroller, we have an accumulator. We have an accumulator and also register set from R0 to R7. Okay, so each is of 8 bits. So they are all of 8 bits. Along with that, we also use the data pointer, DPTR. This is of 16-bit. Here, so this can be split into two as, so data pointer low and also data pointer high. So each of 8-bit. Now, our point is the immediate addressing mode. Here the syntax for this is, I can write as move a comma hash 55h. Here I am using specifically the symbol hash. Hash denotes that we are sending a value 55 into a. So here what happens? So this a becomes 01 01 01 01. So this is 5 and this is 5. So this is the first one called as immediate addressing mode. Okay, hope it is understood. Next, we are going for the second one, register addressing mode. Register addressing mode. So register addressing mode means we are just taking the values stored in the registers and sharing that with the accumulator in this 8051. Here, so this can be done as move a comma r1. If supposing move r1 comma hash 01h, now what happens, this 01 is being sent into r1 and whatever the value is in r1 is sent into the accumulator. Now here what happens in this step here what is happening. R1 is stored 0 0 0 0 0 0 1. Okay, 0 0 0 1. It is the notation for 1. Okay, so this is 0 and this is 1. 0 1 H. Now move A comma R. So A comma R1 means the value stored in R1 is being sent into the accumulator. Now here what happens? Accumulator value becomes the same value which is in R1. 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 1. Now here in this 8051, here we cannot write move R1 comma R2. So this is invalid. So writing of such move R1 comma R2 is invalid. We cannot exchange the information within the registers. Okay. So this is called as register addressing mode. Means here we are just sharing the value in the registers with the accumulator. Accumulator is the one specifically we use for arithmetic and logic operations. Okay. And here, so it is about the next one called as register addressing mode, and the third one is called as dynamic addressing mode. Dynamic addressing mode. So dynamic addressing mode, here comes the concept of, okay, accessing the value stored in the memory location. Here, accessing the value, stored in the memory location. Now, here, you may ask, how can we do that? So we can access the value stored in the memory location as of such. Here, if I write move A comma 07H. So what is happening here? Okay. So prior to that, I will write move R7 comma hash 70H. Okay. Now, here what is happening here? R7 is a register. Register R7 is storing the value 72. And here, next I am writing move A comma 07H. So 07 is the address of register R7. Okay, so 07, it is the address of register R7. Here, so first what happens, when this instruction is being executed, here 72, the value 72 will be stored in the register R7. So register R7 has an address 07, 07, 06, 05, like that. So these are all the addresses. Now, 07, here we have 72 stored. Now, the second instruction, move A comma 07H, the value 72 will be sent into the accumulator. Here, accumulator will be having the value 72H. So, it is the way we are accessing, the value stored in the address, in other words, the memory location. And the next thing, the fourth thing, we are going to see about, okay, indirect addressing mode. Okay, indirect addressing mode. So, indirect addressing, in other words, I can say it is like a pointer which we do in our C language or any other high-level language. we use @symbol, accessing the value indirectly stored in the, accessing the value with the help of register. Specifically we use @symbol. Specifically we use @symbol. Here the register we use is register we can use only or not and are. Okay. And here how we can move or not comma hash 55h. Okay. And then move a comma @ or not. Now what happens upon executing this instruction, R0 would be storing the value 55H. R0 would be storing the value 55H. Now here this acts upon ignoring the symbol @, it acts as a memory location. In 55H here, if I have a value FF, now this FF would be stored in the accumulator. So getting the point, move R0,55H is the value. Now, R0 means whatever is being stored. Here I am storing the address. Okay. So whatever is stored in that memory location 55H is being sent into the accumulator. Now, accumulator becomes as FFH. And the last and final one, it is indexed at the symbol. Indexed at the symbol. So why this is used? This is being used to access the values stored, in lookup table, or a series of values. So now I can write move, So dptr comma hash 1002h, then move, So a comma hash 01h. Now move c a comma dptr. Now in dptr also here I am storing a value, say something in in 1002. Here I am having a value something as 45. Now what happens? I am here, so 1003, I am having 47. Now, so dptr plus 1 is 1003, and whatever the value here is being stored into the accumulator. So here it is treating this as an address. So this value plus the value in the accumulator, both of them it is being considered as an address. The value in this address is being sent into the accumulator. Hence, accumulator gets the value as 47H. So, this is a brief explanation about addressing modes in 8051. Five things we have seen. First is immediate, register, and direct, and indirect, and indexed addressing. So, thank you very much. And also here, and specifically we will be using always the register addressing mode, and also the immediate addressing mode, Immediate addressing mode, it is used to store the values. So thank you very much.